back to Fish Food. I'd like to start out with a story, not so much a joke, but maybe a story of optimism that that brings to the table some of the things that we're dealing with here. A small rural town hadn't seen rain for weeks. The crops were dying, and the fields were brown, and the people's spirits were anxious. Sounds a little bit like us. When weeks turned to months, the community's three churches called a joint meeting on the town square to pray for rain. The pastors asked the townspeople to bring an object of faith to help inspire the prayers. On the appointed day, everyone showed up to ask God for rain, and the pastors were deeply moved to see the many inspirational objects that were brought along: Bibles, crosses, candles, flowers. But the prayer meeting really got going when a young boy showed up with an umbrella. So how about you? Are you bringing an umbrella to the corona situation, or are you bringing an N95 mask, or maybe better yet, are you bringing the vaccine that we need to overcome the worldly situation that we're in right at the moment? I just thought that was a neat little story to introduce us today. So again, welcome back. This is Fish Food. These moments are just small snippets of activity that are going on in my life and a little bit of the things that I'm studying and looking into. One of the things that I've kind of spent my energy on for this time is the book Instruments in the Redeemer's Hand. So there are a couple things here that I would like to introduce as well. And again, some of this is almost verbatim out of the book, just because it really does seem to be quite beneficial. I decided to meet outside, had a little fire going. Hopefully you can see okay. It looks pretty blaring back there, so hopefully you can see me okay and hear me okay. Last week I was talking a little bit about how change is in our midst during this time, and we will end up with a new normal. In the Bible, it talks about the change as being redemption or redeemed, and how Christ will redeem us and then restore us. So just wanted to continue that thought. And again, a lot of this is straight out of the book, and so bear with me here. It says, hope is only to be found in Jesus Christ, the King of Kings. In Him, lasting personal heart change is possible. People struggling with life in a fallen world often want explanations, when what they really need is imagination. People need to look at their families, neighbors, friends, cities, jobs, histories, and churches, and see the kingdom. They need to look at a city and see the glorious company of the redeemed being gathered amidst the brutal spiritual battle, to live in union with God. They need to look at their children and see a Redeemer pursuing their hearts for His own. They need to scan history and see God accomplishing His purpose. People need to see the shining hope of human existence. People can know, love, and serve God. They can commune with Him forever and form a community of love that is possible no other way. I see from this past Sunday's message from Renaissance that similar hope and desire came from Pastor Darwin. And what an exciting time that was to experience being taught and led from Ecuador, right here in our community of in Michigan. And that was just an exciting time for me. Hopefully everybody else enjoyed that as well. Let me continue. As sinners, we have a natural bent to turn away from the Creator to serve the creation. I see that happen so often that even in these days, these Corona days, we're thinking about the creation itself, the creation of jobs and establishments and et cetera. And we're turning our eyes away from the Creator Himself. And the true redemption will come when we put our eyes back again on the Creator and depend upon Him for all things. And let me continue here. We dig into the mound of human ideas to extract tiny shards of insight. But before long, disappointment returns. We must not offer people a system of redemption, a set of insights and principles. We offer people a Redeemer. In His power, we find the hope and help we need to defeat the most powerful enemies. Hope rests in the grace of the Redeemer, the only real means of lasting change. This is what separates believers from our culture's psychology. A lot of times, we ourselves as believers fall into this psychology. We have this idea that the Bible can find us the answers when we are looking to find out about a verse on blank topic. And so, what we need really is to realize that the Bible isn't an encyclopedia for us to find the answers in that way, but instead a story of God's plan to rescue hopeless and helpless humanity. We cannot treat the Bible as a collection of therapeutic insights. To do so distorts its message and will not lead to lasting change. We don't offer people a system. We point them to a Redeemer. He is the hope. Well, how about you during this time? Who are you putting, or what are you putting your hope in? Hopefully it is God Himself, and that your dependency is not on the system or the creation that God has created. How are you doing? How are things going for you during this time of separation, and what is your hope for the future of us getting back together again as a body, as you interact with people or futurely interact with people at stores and at restaurants? What are you putting your hope in? And I'll just leave it there and ask that if you have any further comment, feel free to contact me. Most of you can find me at the store, or you can always leave me a message. There's my phone number is there in the directory, so feel free to contact me if you have any questions or concerns. So there it is. Hopefully it didn't get too dark. I know it is getting quite a bit dark, and the fire is still quite bright in the back. So again, hopefully you enjoyed this, and hope to see you soon. That's all. Bye-bye.